Good day, students. Today we continue our discussion on readers' reaction. For the purpose of a reminder, this concept is under electrochemistry. And what is electrochemistry? Electrochemistry is a branch of a chemistry that deals with interrelationship between chemistry and electricity. That is, how chemical reactions are made to occur by means of electricity, and how electricity are made to pass by means of a chemical reaction. In this lesson, our focal point will be on writing and balancing of equations of Redox reaction. Writing and balancing of equations of Redox reaction. In writing a Redox reaction, the reactants and products are generally in the ionic form, except those of metals and those that are molecular like gases and water. Apart from this, every other species taking part in a Redox reaction must be written in the ionic form. For instance, if you look at the oxidation of aqueous iron 2 chloride by chlorine gas, let's look at that reaction, how it's going to look like. I will write the normal reaction first. Iron 2 chloride solution is in aqueous state. When you oxidize it with chlorine gas, you are going to have iron 3 chloride, FeCl3, aqueous. Let me balance it. Here you have what? 4 chlorine, there you have what? Let me put 2 here. So that becomes making what? Making 4. Then 2 goes there. So the equation is balanced. Now in ionic form, it's going to be like this. 2 Fe2+4Cl- aqueous state. Aqueous plus Cl2. This one will not be in the ionic form because it's molecular, chlorine gas. Then you are going to have 2 Fe3+ 6Cl-. So this is how this equation will look like in the ionic form. So that's how to write Redox reaction. It must be in the ionic form, apart from those that are atomic in nature like metals, and those that are molecular in nature like gases and water. Now, how do we balance Redox reaction? The way we balance Redox reaction is different from the way we balance normal chemical reaction. There are rules to follow when balancing Redox reaction. And this equation can be in 3 media. It can be in acidic medium, it can be in basic medium, and it can be neutral. But for today, we are going to look at balancing of equation of Redox reaction in acidic medium. And to do that, there are rules, up to 8 steps. I have them pasted on the board there. Let's go and check the rules. So these are the rules. The first step is you are assigned oxidation number to atoms that have changed. Number 2, separate the reactions into oxidation half and reduction half. Then 3, balance all the atoms except those of hydrogen and oxygen. Then the number 4 step is add appropriate number of water molecules to balance oxygen atom. Then 5, add appropriate number of hydrogen ion to balance hydrogen atoms. Add enough electrons to decide with more positive charges or less negative charges. Then number 7 step, multiply the half reactions by appropriate coefficients to balance electron loss and gain. Then the last step, you have to add the 2 half reactions and subtract any duplication. So these are the steps to follow when balancing redox reaction in acidic medium. Let's look at example. Example one, balance the following redox reaction in acidic medium using ion electron method, and this is the equation. The equation is MnO4 minus aqueous plus sulfur 4 oxide SO2, which is gas. So you have what? Mn2 plus tetra something 6 ion. So this is the equation. So you have to balance. It's a redox reaction. So the first thing to do, you have to assign, that's the first step, assign oxidation number to every atom that have changed. So let's look at the atoms that take part in this reaction. Manganese, if you calculate the number of manganese here, it's going to be plus 7. We did that in our last class. So the number of manganese here is plus 7. Oxygen is C minus 2. So oxygen is not changing. Oxygen is minus 2 here. Minus 2 here, minus 2 here. So this is not changing. But sulfur 2, change. Sulfur here is what? It's plus 4. Plus 4. Then going to the product side, manganese is what? Plus 2. While sulfur here is what? Plus 6. So from here, you can easily divide it into what? Into half reaction, meaning the reduction half and the oxidation half. And if you remember, what the definition of oxidation and reduction says, oxidation is increase in oxidation number, while reduction is decrease in oxidation number. If you look at manganese from plus 7 to plus 2, it's decreasing. That means that is what? That is a reduction. Then sulfur from plus 4 to plus 6 is increasing. That is what? Oxidation. So let's separate this into what? Oxidation half and reduction half. So let's, it's better use a table. So this side is what? Reduction. While the other side is going to be what? Oxidation. So let's write the reduction half from plus 7 to plus 2. So that's reduction. So MnO4 minus to Mn2 plus. This is reduction half. Then let's go to oxidation half. SO4, I mean SO2, sorry, SO2 to SO4 to minus. So this is oxidation half. Now the next thing is to balance every atom. You balance every atom apart from oxygen and the hydrogen. So let's look at the reduction half. Manganese is 1 here, it is 1 here. So manganese is balanced. Oxidation out, sulfur is 1 here, it is 1 there. Sulfur is balanced. So we have balanced every species apart from hydrogen and oxygen. So the next thing is to balance oxygen. How do you balance oxygen? If you go to the rule, we use water molecule to balance oxygen. Here, you have 4 atoms of what? Of oxygen. Here, you have what? None. So to balance this, you are going to add what? 4 molecules of water to this side in order to balance what? Oxygen. So let's do that. MnO4 minus Mn2 plus what? 4 molecules of what? Water. That's how we balance oxygen. Going to this side, here you have 2 atoms of oxygen, 4. So to balance it, to make it 4-4, you are going to add your 2 molecules of water to this side. SO2 plus what? 2H2O. Then you have what? Let's go for 2 miles. So we have balanced oxygen now. The moment you introduce water molecule, you have also introduced us hydrogen. So the next thing is balance hydrogen atoms. Let me start with the reduction size. Here now I have what? No hydrogen atom. But here I have what? 8 hydrogen atoms. 4 times 2, making it 8. So to balance hydrogen atom, we are going to use what? Hydrogen ion, H plus. So that means I'm going to add what? 8 H plus to this side to balance what? Hydrogen. So let's do that. MaO4 minus plus 8 hydrogen ion to Na2 plus what? 4 molecules of water. So I'll balance the hydrogen atoms there. So let me go to this side. So here too, I have what? 4 hydrogen atoms. 2 times 2. 4. 4 hydrogen atoms. I have none here. So that means I'm going to what? Add 4 hydrogen ion. And that's balance with hydrogen atom. So it would be SO2 plus 2 H2O. Okay. So what's the next thing? The next thing is to balance electron loss and gain. Balance electron loss and gain. And to do that, alright, let's just balance electron loss and gain. To do that, you are going to add electron to the side with more positive charges. That's where you are going to add electron. Now, let's look at this side. This side is having more positive charges. All in all, it's having what? 7 positive charges. How do I know that? These 8 positive charges, 8. And this is what? This one electron. So you take away this one electron from what? The 8 positive charges you have here, you are going to have what? 7. So this side is having what? 7 positive charges. Why this side is having what? Just 2 positive charges. And you have to add what? Electron to the side with more positive charges. So you are adding to this side. So how many will you have now to make it 2? This side is having 7, this side is having 2. So in order to balance it with the 2, you are going to add what? 5 electrons to this side. You have to make it 2. So Na4 minus plus H plus 5 electrons. Na2 plus 4H2O. So we have balanced electron loss and gain at the reduction side. Let's go to the junior side. Here you have 0 positive charges. 0. And here you have what? 2. How is it 2? You take away this 2 from 4. Because here this 4 positive charges, right? And you have 2 electrons here. So if you take away this electron from 4 here, that means you have what? 2 positive charges here. And here you have what? None. So what do you do? You add what? 2 to this side. Because you have to add electron to the side, it was more positive charges. So if you add 2 here, that means there will be no positive charges there again. And yet you don't have any positive charges. So you have what? SO2 plus 2H2O. SO4 2 minus plus 4H plus plus 2 electrons. So the next thing now is to balance the number of electrons. And how do you do that? You interchange the coefficient of the electrons. Now, here you have 5 electrons, there you have 2 electrons. So you interchange the coefficient. You use 5 to multiply the oxidation side, then you use 2 to multiply the reduction side. All the species there. So doing that now, if you use 2 here now to multiply everything here, you are going to have 2 MnO4 minus plus 16 H plus plus 10 electrons, giving you 2 Mn2 plus plus 8 molecules of water. So I've used what? The coefficient of electron here to multiply everything here. So I'm going to do the same thing. I will take the coefficient of electron here to multiply everything I have at that size. So and the coefficient here is what? 5. So that will be what? 5 SO2 plus 10 H2O 5 SO4 2 minus plus 20 iodine plus plus 10 electrons. So I've used 5 to multiply everything here. 5 SO2, 10 H2O, 5 SO4 2 minus, 20 H plus, and 10 electrons. Then the second to last step is to add the two R reactions and subtract any duplicates. You add the two R reactions, then you subtract any duplicates. Alright, so let me add the two half reaction. So this is a reduction. Then oxidation half, that's a 5 SO2 plus 10 H2O. So 5 SO4 2 minus plus 2H 20 plus plus 10 electrons. So this is the oxidation side. Oxidation. So I want to add it to now. I will subtract any duplicates. Now that duplicate I have here, I have what? 10 electrons. 10 electrons. They are duplicates. So 10 minus 10, now it gives you 0. So electron. 10 electron will cancel the electron. Is there any other duplicates? Alright, let me add. That's 2 MnO4 plus 5 SO2 plus. Now, is there any duplicates? Yes. Here you have what? 16 hydrogen, there you have what? 20. So it's a duplicate. You subtract 20 from 16. That would be what? That would be 4, so plus 4 electro hydrogen ion, then that's what coming here. You have what 2 Mn2 plus plus 5 SO4 2 minus, then water molecule, then duplicate. Yes, this is 10 here, this is what 8, so you subtract. Then from 8, you have what, 2 molecules of water plus what, 2 molecules of water. So this is the balanced equation. Let's see, is it balanced? Yes. 2 manganese, 2 manganese. How many oxygen? Here you have 8, 10, that is what, 18. Here you have what, 10, 2 times 4. Yes, plus 10, 18. Yes, this is 20. Yes, it's balanced. the equation is balanced. So this is balance redox reaction. Let's look for another example. Check it very well before we move to another example. Okay, so this is the balance equation. Let us move to another example. Example 2. Still in acidic medium. So the equation is Cr2O7 2 minus plus C2O4 2 minus. Then you have Cr3 plus CO2. Aqueous. That. So this is another example. So we still apply the same step. The first thing you do, you assign oxidation number to every atom that have changed. Alright? Chromium here, if you do the calculation very well, chromium here is going to be plus 6. Plus 6. Why? Carbon here is going to be, let me calculate it, that's 6204. Let me complete with that. C2 plus minus 2 times 4 equals to minus 2. So you have C2 minus 8 equals to minus 2. C2 equals to minus 2 plus 8. So C2 equals plus 6. So C equals to what? Plus 3. So carbon here is plus 3. Why chromium here, that one is straightforward, is still plus 3. Then this carbon 4 is that. So carbon here is plus 4. So these are the atoms that have changed and have assigned what oxidation number to them. So from there, you divide the reactions into oxidation half and reduction half. So again, you see tabular that form. This is a reduction. And this is a oxidation. Okay? So which one is reducing? From plus 6 to plus 3. That is reduction. So the half reaction is Cr2O7 2 minus to Cr3 plus. Then this one is increasing. That's oxidation from plus 3 to plus 4. So you have C2O4 2 minus to CO2. So I have separated the reaction into two half reactions. Now the next thing is to balance every atom apart from oxygen and nitrogen. So let me balance every atom apart from oxygen and nitrogen. Here, yeah, chromium is 2, right? It's 2 here, but it's 1 here. So that to balance it, I will put 2 here. So I balance chromium. I will still leave what? Oxygen. Let me go to the oxygen side. Carbon here is 2. Why carbon here is what is 1? Now to balance carbon, I put 2 here. Okay? So I balance every other atom now, apart from oxygen and hydrogen. So the next thing is to balance oxygen. Here I have 7 atoms of oxygen. Here I have none. So what do I do? I'm going to add what? 7 water molecules to this side. Remember, we use water molecules to balance oxygen. So it's Cr2O7 2 minus to Cr3 plus. That's our 7H2O. So I balance the oxygen. So let me go to this side. Here I have what? 4 atoms of oxygen. Here I have 4. So automatically the oxygen is balanced already. 4, 4. So there's no point adding what? Adding a water molecule. because I have oxygen here, I also have what, 4 here. So oxygen is balanced at the oxygen star. So the next thing is to balance the hydrogen. Here now I have what, 7 atoms of hydrogen. I mean 14, because this is 7 times 2. So this 14 atoms of hydrogen. I have none here. So what do I do? I'm going to add what? 14 hydrogen AM to this side. That's balance what? Hydrogen atom.
So Cr2O7 minus plus 14H plus. Okay? That's 2 Cr.
So I balance what? Hydrogen. So I don't put balance hydrogen here because there's not hydrogen at all. So what's the next thing? The next thing is to balance the electron loss and gain. And remember, you have to add what? You have to add electron to the side with more positive charges. So let's look. This 14 hydrogen ion, and you have 2 electrons there. So that means all in all here you have what? You have 12 positive charges. 12. You have 12. If you get, if you take 2 from 14, you're going to have 12. And here you have what? You have a 6. This you have 3 here, 2 times 3 is a 6. So here's 12, here's or here's 6. So what do I do? I have to add your 6 electrons to balance the charges. 6 electrons to this side. So it's going to be what? 6. If you take 6 away from 12, this one remain what? This one remain 6, and this one is 6. So I'm going to add those 6 electrons to the side in terms of positive charges. Cr2O7 plus 14H plus plus 6 electrons. Right? Then you have a 2Cr3 plus plus 7H2O. Alright, so let me balance electron loss and gain at this side too. Remember, you have got electron to the side with more positive charges or less negative charges. So here you have what? 2 electrons. And here I have what? None. So now to balance it, now I'm going to add 2 electrons to this side. So there will be 2 electrons here, there will be 2 electrons there. I'm adding to this side because there is no positive charge here. So here it's having what, less negative charge. In fact, it's not having any. So I'm going to add 2 electrons to this side. C2O42 minus. There's 2 electrons. Okay? So what's the next thing? The next thing is to interchange the coefficient of the electrons and use it to multiply each half. Here I have 6 electrons, and here I have 2 electrons. Meaning I'm going to use 6 to multiply everything at the position side, and I'm going to use 2 to multiply everything at a reduction side. So, being that now I'm going to have what? 2 Cr2O7 2 minus plus 28. H plus what? 12 electrons, then going to have what? 4 Cr3 plus what? Plus 14 H2O. Okay? So here I'm going to use what? 6. 6. So if I use 6 to multiply what I have here now, I'm going to have what? 6C2O42 minus plus 12CO2 plus 12 electrons. So the next thing is to add the 2 half reactions and subtract any duplicates. So let me write the reduction half first. I have a 2Cr2O7 2 minus plus 28 hydrogen ion
plus 6 electrons. Then I have a...
So let me write the oxidation half. Oxidation half is a 6 or C2O4 2 minus 12 CO2 plus 12 electrons. So this oxidation. Alright, so let me subtract any duplicates. Yes, I can see duplicates here. 12 electrons. So 12 minus 12, that's what? Electron counter electron. Alright, so let me write and combine the equation now. That's 2Cr2O7 2 minus plus 6C2O4 2 minus plus electron. I'm averaging it on there. And here is 28. What do you have any duplicates here? No duplicates. So that's going to be what, 28 H plus, then 2, 4, say 3 plus 12 CO2. So this oxidation. Alright, this is a balanced equation. But if you look at the coefficients, you can see something that they are divisible by 2. Look at the coefficients of all the species, they are divisible by 2. So we can divide it by 2. They are all divisible. They are not divisible really like that, but since they are divisible, so balanced equation is going to be Cr2O7 2 minus plus, that's going to be 3, C2O4 2 minus plus 14 H plus. Then you have what? 2Cr3 plus 6 CO2. So this is the balanced equation. Yeah, we look at it very well together. Everything is balanced. Assignment before I take my leave. Very simple assignment. Assignment. MnO4 minus aqueous plus Fe2 plus aqueous as well. Then Mn2 plus Fe3 plus. So try this. You follow the step I followed. You are going to get it very simple. That's the assignment. I will pause here for today. I will continue from our next class on how to balance redox reaction in alkaline medium. So until then, please ensure you stay safe. Bye bye.